During the 18th century, much like today, tourists traveled to Venice in great numbers. They came to admire Venice's unique setting on the sea, but they also came for the numerous festivals, ceremonies, and processions that transformed the city into a great spectacle for a large part of the year. In this month's video, I would like to explore how one of the main attractions, Carnival, was captured in painting by Canaletto, through a close look at two wonderful paintings here at the Wallace Collection. During the 18th century, Venice became the stage of a burgeoning tourist industry. Most visitors were undertaking the Grand Tour, a period of extensive European travel by upper-class young gentlemen in order to complete their education. Most were British, but there were also Irish, French, Germans, and Scandinavians, and in time, women, older men, and children also took part. Many came to Venice to admire the city's spectacular setting and its impressive architecture, to experience the numerous theaters, opera houses, and concert halls, and to see great Renaissance art by the likes of Titian and Veronese. Others came purely for the fun to be had in the numerous casinos and brothels. But it was the colorful public spectacles that held enduring fascination and made Venice stand apart from the rest of Europe. And it was Canaletto, the leading 18th century veduta or topographical view painter, who marvelously captured these ephemeral events in paint. Carnival was and still is one of the main attractions to Venice. Carnival season began on the Feast of St. Stephen on the 26th of December and lasted until the start of Lent in spring. It held immense appeal due to the countless pageants, masked balls, outdoor plays and festivities organized during this period. This wonderful pair of views at the Wallace Collection shows a rowing race that took part during Carnival in the picture on the left, and the Giovedì Grasso or Maundy Thursday festival that marked the end of Carnival season in the picture on the right. The excitement of the crowds is infectious. The annual regatta or public rowing race on the Grand Canal, the main thoroughfare through Venice, took place during Carnival on the 2nd of February, the Feast of the Purification of the Virgin. Public rowing races had a long history in Venice, the first one having been held in 1315. An 18th century guidebook described regattas as one of the happiest entertainments. The standard course was approximately 8 kilometers long and spanned a large portion of the city. The race began at the Punta di Sant'Antonio in the east, which is today's public gardens. It progressed through the Bacino di San Marco, Venice's inner harbor, past the Molo, which is the broad quay by the Doge's Palace, and continued up the Grand Canal past the famous Rialto Bridge up to the north by today's railway station, at which point the boats turned around and came back down the canal, passing the Rialto Bridge once more and finishing at the Volta di Canal, the canal's sharpest bend. Canaletto's view is taken from the Volta di Canal when the contestants first pass it and continue north. There's a glimpse of the Rialto Bridge in the distance in the center of the painting. In due course, the race would end here with winners awarded prizes from the Macchina della Regatta, the ornate temporary floating pavilion, part of which is visible in the left foreground of the painting. The one-oared gondola race is nearly missed among the hustle and bustle of the spectators who've come to watch it. People from all walks of life watch the race from lavishly decorated boats in the water and from the quays. Every window, balcony, and door is occupied by spectators eagerly watching and cheering. Several figures in the foreground sport the traditional carnival dress known as the bauta, which consisted of a white mask and black cape. The celebrations held on Giovedì Grasso, or Fat Thursday, the last Thursday during Carnival, were equally exciting. This view shows the piazzetta, flanked on the left by the Doge's Palace, and on the right by Jacopo Sansovino's library. This was the gateway into the city, emphasized by the twin columns in the distance, surmounted by Venice's patron saints, the Lion of St. Mark in the column on the left, and St. Theodore on the right. The center of the painting is occupied by an impressively ornate macchina or temporary structure built especially for the occasion. Before it, on an elevated stage, rival teams of acrobats undertake the Forza d'Ercole, or Force of Hercules, an impressive human pyramid that tested endurance, acrobatic skill, agility, and above all, balance. Two rival teams climbed one above the other, holding hands and helping each other with long poles and beams. Whoever managed to reach the highest point won. Here we see the man on the highest level upside down doing a handstand. Up to 24 acrobats could participate, and in Canaletto's painting, there are 21. The crowd is packed and spectators look on in awe and delight. Here too, many wear the Bauta carnival attire. Two Commedia dell'arte figures in the foreground are engaged in an intriguing exchange that has caught the attention of nearby onlookers. The Commedia dell'arte was a popular comedy troupe with stock characters that performed improvised sketches, often outside, especially during carnival. The figures shown are Arlecchino, the clown with his patched suit, who always provided comic relief, on the left, and Pulcinella with his tall white hat, who played the charlatan, on the right. The ropes stretching diagonally across and beyond the picture in the upper right are for another sensational event, the Volo del Turco, or Flight of the Turk, where an acrobat would fly from the Campanile or Tower of San Marco, part of which is visible on the right, to the Doge's Loggia at the left, so they'd fly all across the painting. There he would recite verses in the Doge's honor and receive flowers. A version of this human feat is perhaps better visible in this print. Legend has it that a young Turkish acrobat first did this in 1548 from a boat anchored in the water. He apparently walked on a rope with just the use of a balance pole to the balcony of the Campanile. During his descent, he paid homage to the Doge, and he made such a sensation that the event was reenacted every year until an accident in 1759 prevented it from continuing. Today, the tradition has been reinstated with proper safety measures in place and has been transformed into the Flight of the Angel. These events were all highly sensorial. Along with being visually stimulating, one has to imagine the sounds that emanated from the crowds, the cheers, the laughter, the applause. Carnival brought and continues to bring people together for a period of liberation and relief from the everyday and from social norms. Canaletto effectively captured the spirit of carnival, enabling us to continue to enjoy it to this day. Thank you so much for tuning in. We hope to welcome you to see these wonderful paintings in the flesh, along with the rest of the superb works of art here at the Wallace Collection, very soon.